The topic is concepts of causation. So these are the concepts of causation of a disease from public health dentistry. So there are various concepts. So first is epidemiological triad, multifactorial causation. Then there is natural history of disease, web of causation, risk factors and risk group, iceberg of disease and spectrum of disease. So in this video, I'm going to explain about web of causation and iceberg of disease. So starting off with the first one, that is the iceberg of the disease. So now, what is iceberg? So it is a large part of ice that has been broken off from the snow formed glacier and it is floating on the water. And only 1/9 of the iceberg it is seen above the water. So now what is this iceberg of disease or iceberg phenomena? So basically it is a metaphor which is emphasizing that in every health problem, the number of the known cases of the disease, it is outweighed by those that remain undiscovered. And it forms this, the larger part that is unseen in an iceberg. So basically it's like the health professional, they see only a small part of the illness in the community, just as only a small part of the iceberg is seen above the water. And this is what is known as tip of an iceberg. So your iceberg, basically it has these three parts. So the floating tip, so this is the waterline and this is the submerged area or the submerged portion. So this floating tip, it is what the dentist can see in the community, and that are those clinical cases. Then submerged portion, it is the hidden mass of the disease, and it's like the disease which are pre-symptomatic or the disease which are undiagnosed or the carriers which are present in the community, it remains in that submerged portion. And the waterline, it is the demarcation between the apparent and unapparent disease. So basically it's like, since many inapparent infection, they can be transmitted and they can produce disease in other. So it is not sufficient to direct disease management procedure solely to clinical apparent cases. So this is the iceberg of the dental caries. So in this, so this is the portion which can be seen and this is the portion which is submerged. So basically when there are the lesions into the pulp, so the patient, he'll be symptomatic, there will be pain and this can be seen clinically. And this is the first part. This is D4, is nothing but it is detectable at level 4. So D1 is detectable at level 1, 2, 3 and 4. So these are the parts which can be seen. So the lesions, the pulp. So then there are these clinical detectable lesions in the dentin. And then there is this clinically detectable cavities which are limited to enamel. And the cases of this, in that you have to give preventive and operative care. It is usually advised. And this is seen in a classical epidemiological survey. So these is like the thing that a dentist can see easily. Now these are the things that are submerged. So that is clinically detectable enamel lesion with intact surface. And the lesions which are detectable only with additional diagnostic aids. And these are the subclinical initial lesion in the dynamic state of progression or regression. And this can be seen on clinical examination over here. If there is a subclinical initial lesion, there is no active care, and in this you are giving a preventive care. So this is the iceberg of disease for dental caries. Now what is the iceberg of periodontitis? So this is the portion that can be seen or diagnosed easily. So if the patient is coming with mobility, so that is the area it can be diagnosed easily. So these are the parts that are submerged. So this is gingival recession, bleeding gums and pocket. So it can be diagnosed after radiographic and clinical aids. And this is the subclinical bone destruction and gingival inflammation, which remains mostly undiagnosed. So this is the iceberg of periodontitis. Then this is the iceberg of oral cancer. The diagnosed part of oral cancer is when the patient is saying he has difficulty in swallowing. Then there are chewing problems. Then if the tongue, there are changes with the tongue oral cavity, and it can be easily diagnosed. Now this is the submerged area in which there is no soreness, if there is pre-malignant conditions and lesions which are present. So these are like leukoplakia, lichen planus, lumps, ulcer, and they are detectable only after biopsy and aspiration. And these are the undiagnosed or wrongly diagnosed things, which can be lymph node enlargement or weight loss. So this remains the undiagnosed part. So we cannot diagnose, depending upon this, that the person, he can have oral cancer. So this is nothing but iceberg of disease. So what is the conclusion of this? So the ultimate purpose of the iceberg phenomena is to spread awareness in people that disease may not look as severe as they are. So some people think that a disease is normal, but actually it may not be that normal. So this is nothing but iceberg phenomena. Now what is web of causation? So this was the term which was coined by McMahon and Pugh. So it is applicable in certain diseases, especially if there are these chronic diseases where the causative agent may be unknown or uncertain, and the disease, it is a result of interaction of multiple factors. So removal of some of them or even one of them, that is the important link, it may be sufficient to control the disease. So web of causation is nothing but a disease, it is caused due to many factors. So for example, for dental caries. So if a patient, he is belonging to a low socioeconomic status, because of that he has lack of knowledge. Because of lack of knowledge, he has poor oral hygiene, and because of this, there is this cariogenic microorganisms which leads to dental caries over time. So this can be one factor which leads to dental caries, that can be low socioeconomic group. The next factor can be malaligned teeth. So if there is malocclusion, because of that there is poor oral hygiene, again there is cariogenic microorganisms and dental caries. This can be the other factor. Next can be age. In advanced age, the saliva, it is reduced. Again, there is poor oral hygiene with advanced age. Then there is again cariogenic microorganism, and with time it leads to dental caries. Then the next is this lack of knowledge. It may lead to this diet which is conducive to caries. So if a person, he has lack of knowledge, because of that he is more into eating that diet which has more sugar, and which can lead to cariogenic microorganisms, and then with over time it leads to dental caries. So there is nothing but web of causation. And even if you remove one of this link, any one of the important link amongst this web, then it may prevent the dental caries formation. So this is nothing but the web of causation, and these are like two main important concepts of causation. And that was it of this video. Thank you so much.